fantastic edition of the favorite show. Let's discuss on your number one TV. It's just Tube TV with your favorite duo, the Olamide and is a crazy. You know how we do it on. Let's discuss. Well, before I proceed, let my colleague introduce himself.
Hi guys, this is Let's Discuss on Gist TV. And it's not new to you that on this platform we get to bring to you gist news and updates on gossips, entertainment, politics, education. You can name it. We get to bring to you trendings. And today won't be an exception. It's going to be informative, expository, and of course, entertaining, of course, at the same time. But before we go deep into today's discussion, why don't we go on a very short break? Well, today on Let's Discuss, as you know, it won't be an exception. Well, we'll be discussing about the EFCC and the NDDC. What do we have about the EFCC? What do we have about the NDDC? Well, I get my colleague will introduce you to the gist.
Well, it's no news that the NDDC boss, Professor Pondey, yesterday Monday, 28th of July 2020, he fainted at the committee sitting where he was interrogated for over 1 hour. Well, he was interrogated for how he mismanaged the 80 billion naira fund from February 2020 to May 2020 that was issued to the NDDC, the IMC, that is the Interim Management Committee of the NDDC, over the affairs of the Niger Delta. Well, before we delve into this matter, a whole lot of people have been questioning that what is the full meaning of NDDC? A whole lot of people want to know the full meaning of NDDC, their purpose in Nigeria. Well, NDDC as a parastatal in Nigeria stands for the Niger Delta Development Commission. The NDDC sees to the affairs of the Niger Delta, but they are accountable to the Ministry of Niger Delta under the supervision of the Minister for Niger Delta, that is Godswill Akpabio. So yesterday, the NDDC boss, Professor Pondey, at the sitting of the committee, he was interrogated by the members of the House of Representatives, led by an honorable member of the parliament. But there was a drama, this has built a whole lot of commotion in Nigeria that why would he, during this period, he should be accountable for how he spent this money. Akrisi, what do you see to this?
Well, why don't we take a good look at this man himself, Pondey, Professor Daniel Pondey. Well, he's a graduate of University of Lagos. He graduated from the University of Lagos Medicine and Surgery, Department of Medicine and Surgery. Per se, that is, he's a medical doctor. Well, he proceeded to University of Nottingham, to get his doctorate degree from microbiology. Now, per se, he's a lecturer in Bayelsa State. And he started his career in the year 2001. And on February 19, year 2020, he was appointed by the Nigerian President Muhammadu Buhari, to the position of being the acting managing director of the NDDC, Niger Delta Development Commission. That means he's actually overseeing all the affairs of the Niger Delta, ranging from all sorts of things, their education and the likes, medical aspects and the likes. And I believe he has bosses that he actually give reports to. Now, judging from what actually happened yesterday, on Monday, July 28th, year 2020, he slumped and fainted while he was being interrogated by this panel of him misappropriating and,
mismanaging
of funds. Well, I believe there are billions of nairas from palliatives, and another billions of naira from other educational aspects. Now 80 billion naira plus, with another addition of another 70 something billion naira plus. That is about 143 billion naira. How will you mismanage 143 billion naira and you're unable to account for that? Well, even if you are going to do magumago, if you are going to do anyhow with these funds, you should be able to say something tangible that you were giving out bread, maybe you were giving out. He couldn't say anything per se that he actually spent this money on. No education, no scholarship for any students, no health in this pandemic. No. It's uncalled for. It's actually uncalled for. Now, he was brought to book sometimes last week.
Mm-hmm.
Last week, Thursday. Now, he actually was unable to give account of how he actually mismanaged these funds. Now, he had to scatter the meeting and left. He walked out of these panels. Now, he was told to come back again on July 28th, year 2020. That was on Monday. That was yesterday. Now, after 45 minutes of interrogation, maybe Baba doesn't know a way out of this issue on how he spent 143 billion naira. The only escape route he could find was to slump and faint. And this has actually became a trend in Nigeria. Now, we have other politicians who have done it, the likes of Senator Dino Melaye. He was being questioned. He fainted. I think they actually thought Nigerians are fool. Now, they thought this is the only escape route from being interrogated from the misappropriation and mismanagement of funds. Olamide, what do you see to that?
Well, in a way, let's delve back to last week.
Okay.
He was grilled by this same panel last week, by the same committee.
Mm-hmm.
Last week. So, according to him, he said the head of this committee, an honorable member of the parliament, the head of this committee is quite interested in a party of this interrogation that he can never interrogate him. So, he walked out of this committee, of this interrogation at the complex.
Okay.
So, the Speaker of the House of Representatives, Honorable Fela Gbajabi Amila, ordered the immediate arrest of Professor Ponde. As of last week, he ordered the IGP to arrest Professor Ponde. We should note that as of last week, Friday, the ex-chairman of the NDDC, the ex-managing director of the NDDC, in a Zoom meeting with the members of the Committee of the House of Representatives, said that some kind of individuals are accumulating this fund of the NDPC to themselves. We should note that this woman, Mrs. Joy, the former, the sacked NDPC managing director, she said some individuals in the parliament are accruing this money to themselves. But as at yesterday,
okay,
after Professor Ponde slumped,
mm-hmm,
Senator Godwill Akpabio, you know, he as minister for the Niger Delta Affairs,
mm-hmm,
he said some of the members of the House of Representatives, mm-hmm, are also they have been awarded contracts that belongs to the Niger Delta. So everything scattered at this point. The chairman of the committee said, it is okay. It is. They want to, you know, I believe they want to cover this thing up.
Yeah. As you said, about covering up.
The thing is, okay, now, as at this morning,
okay,
Honorable Femi Gbajabi Amila,
mm-hmm,
he said Professor Ponde would not be interrogated anymore as at this morning. So he said the files he submitted will be used as he is indisposed. He wished him quick recovery. But I believe if you watch this video closely, there was this person that was trying to resuscitate Professor Ponde. Professor Ponde was believed to be, you know, to have fainted, but he was still trying to remove this guy's hand from his mouth. If you watch the video closely, so closely. So for this, okay, now, as of last week,
mm-hmm,
Professor Ponde said the chairman of this committee will never interrogate him.
Okay.
As a result of the fact that he said this chairman is interested in the part of this interrogation. So for him to have walked away, this chairman steps down and another acting chairman came in. That is the vice chairman of this committee. He interrogated him yesterday.
I think they're actually taking us for a joke.
I believe so.
You know why? Now, what they actually set a panel to interrogate him.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have any rights whatsoever to question this panel that you don't want so person to interrogate him or to be among the panel that will judge and interrogate him. I think he's actually keeping a skeleton in his cupboard. Now, talking about the video that ravaged the internet and social media platforms yesterday on Instagram and Twitter, You know, it was said, it has been reported that in this video, in this short clip, 1 minute clip, if you take a good look at this clip, when he was being interrogated, there was another man sitting somewhere else that was trying to tell all this panel to skip the questions. That they shouldn't interrogate him anymore. That they should skip some questions that he was unable to answer them, or they don't want this kind of questions to actually come up. Because probably he might not be able to answer these questions. You get. Now, in this video again, you claimed you slumped and you fainted. And you were actually facing the table. You were being questioned. You opened your eyes. Now, you came up. You were doing like this. Is that... are you taking Nigerians for a joke? Are we stupid? Someone was trying to resuscitate you from seizure. From you closing your mouth. No, and you were even handling this guy's hands like, guy, don't kill me, don't choke me.
It's quite funny. Man.
It's quite funny. And people had to make a meme of this out of this video. Well, at this juncture, we'll just be cutting on the NDDC issue. Now, let us switch back to Magnus issue, the ex-chairman of EFCC, who was weeks away on July 6th, a good Monday afternoon, July 6th, 2020, to the presidential villa for mismanagement of funds, insubordination, and relooting
of looted
funds. Olamide, what do you say to that?
Well, the case of Magu is quite similar to that of Pondé.
Mm-hmm.
In a way. Okay, let's take, for example, Magu's case. He recovered looted funds.
Exactly. That was the funniest thing.
So for someone to have the kind of money they met in his house,
Jesus,
he's whooping, okay, 3 currencies actually, in dollars, pounds,
and naira.
Billions of naira.
To be exact.
So, but now, I believe, everybody knows the story of Magu. He has been released already.
After 10 days.
And now, there's nothing about him anymore.
Yeah, I heard he was given a suspension letter. That is how this matter would die down. I even heard, aside from this, 3 currencies in billions in his house. He has over hundreds of houses. He transfers funds abroad through a third party
account.
He has investments in oil and Jesus. You are just the chairman of EFCC, reluting looted funds. Now, aside from the fact that he's actually reluting looted funds, there are other funds that have been gotten through or other means, probably through senators and other politicians. Now, we don't have any legal account of how they're actually using these funds.
Okay, what I would say actually is, mm-hmm. this case is kind of ironical.
Okay.
A parastatal, a government agency that is meant to be, you know, arresting and prosecuting corrupt officials.
Mm-hmm.
Their head, in quotes, mm-hmm. is also a corrupt official.
Jesus.
Do you grab that aspect?
Mm-hmm.
The head of a parastatal that is meant to be arresting and prosecuting public officials that are corrupt is also corrupt.
That was why Naya Marley, who was actually arrested by the EFCC a
mm-hmm.
few months ago, he took to his social media page to, well, I wouldn't say laugh of Ibrahim Magu, the ex EFCC chairman. He said, he wrote a lyrics out of his song, Only Everybody, Enilemo Bashadi Barao, or something like that. Now, after hours of posting that meme, he deleted it and he retweeted that anybody can make mistakes and stuff, that we shouldn't laugh this guy off. Well,
that's quite funny.
It's quite funny. Well, at this juncture, we'll be cutting for today on Let's Discuss on all social media platforms. You want to follow us at G2 TV on all social media platforms. You want to follow me at Izakrizi.
I remain your own host, the Olamide of G2 TV. Follow me on all social media at the Olamide_. Next time, keep it real with us. Thank you.